It's a very good tool. I really like visualizing things just to explore our data. And there's something that's special about visualizing things. What I'm showing today is kind of like an end-to-end infrastructure where we, how do we parse people's packages from like the raw source code? We're only going to look at and only have available people's kernels that are public. So we're going to parse that with regular expression, save the output in a table in BigQuery, and then we're going to use the GCP integration and Kaggle's kernels to access that data in the table that we just created. Then we're going to do some cross-join in SQL to analyze and visualize these packages as a network and see how, like, what packages are related to each other. So what we have here is we basically have everybody's kernel is outputted in a file format. We call it a blob in GCS, and that's exported into BigQuery as a really big table. However, that is really hard to aggregate as an analyst level. So what I did here, like internally at Kaggle, with some teammates, I wrote this regular expression to basically parse how people are writing the import code. We try to discover new packages that come up in Kaggle kernels. And if some packages are used very frequently and we don't want them to have to install those packages all the time, therefore, it's built in and automatically built in our Docker image pipeline. This analysis, I'm interested in not just the frequency of each package that's used, but also how these packages are linked to each other. I basically want to see like a cool network. So first is make sure that it's our Kaggle notebook is connected to GCP. So I have my GCP credentials linked to a notebook. This is how you can connect to all these different services that we have GCP integration on. So what I do here, I'm going to run each cell. So the first cell is just a boilerplate. The second is to set up my project ID and set up a BigQuery client. The third one, I already wrote my query and I'm going to go through that, but I'm going to also show that in the BigQuery interface. So it looks like a little bit of a more complicated query. And what that does is first, I'm going to pull up the Python packages that I just derived, and that's fresh. And then the interesting thing is we want to find relationships between packages. So we basically want, it's like a k-choose-2. So we define that package A and B have a relationship if they both coexist in the same kernel. So that how that's done is we basically do an inner join on the same table, so this table and itself. We join that on the kernel blob ID. So we basically can create this exhaustive combination of two packages with the same kernel blob ID. So basically what this does is that I have then grouped by package one and two. It means that package one and package two is NumPy and Pandas. They're almost always, they're like the most frequently appearing pair of packages, and then matplotlib and pandas. But basically, this gives us a really good idea of how much each package pair appears in what we're looking at in all of the public kernels on Kaggle. And note that BigQuery is very fast. It's the data is not small, and usually it'll be a lot slower running on a normal transactional database. Switching to BigQuery has made these kind of analysis much faster. Back to our notebook. And this notebook already has that query that I ran for the first time. And we're going to grab this data into a data frame because we're data scientists and we like notebooks. So I just ran that query and you can see where that is. And now is visualization. In visualization, I found this package that's pretty good. I quite like it. The most famous one is called networkX and it looks pretty good. So I'm going to show it first. But later on in like two cells below, I'm going to show this other package called PyViz, which I like quite a bit for this analysis. I discovered it. So let's use NetworkX first and show the plot. What this one does is we build a graph. So you can see the graph here already is very busy. I can reduce it. I can reduce it to like maybe just 100 of them. What it does is we go through our data frame that looks like this. And for each pair, we add package one and package two each as a node. And this is a relationship between package one and two. So it's like a node called a NumPy, a node called pandas. And the weight between them, it's like the bond between them. So the higher the weight is, the more bond they have between the two nodes. So now we enter PyViz. And for PyViz, it's compatible with networkX. It's very similar. I basically define a graph. Since I already did this for each row, add the packages and the weight into a node, I can now just convert that graph into the PyViz format, and it's a little more interactive. The size of this node is related to how often it's used, so that's cool. We want the larger nodes to show up. And second, we want to see the neighbor, so this is that title line that I just added. So you hover over NumPy. It tells me the neighbors of NumPy being SciPy, scikit-learn, XGBoost, TQDM, and stuff like that. It's not just one thing. It's combining a kind of a range of tools in one task. The more basic part is how powerful BigQuery is, and moving on to later is really utilizing or like harnessing what BigQuery can produce in a very short time to visualize in a Python package of the results got from BigQuery.